The greatest gift you can give this Christmas. During this time of year, the thoughts of many people turn toward the matter of gift giving and receiving. Collectively, we spend a good deal of money and time going from store to store to get the perfect gift for people we love or people we simply want to impress. However, God gave the entire world the greatest gift it would ever receive when He sent His Son, Jesus Christ, into the world in the form of a baby in a manger. Many people at that time and many people today overlooked the utter importance of this wonderful gift the Bible refers to as the unspeakable gift. This gift, which arrived in the humble town of Bethlehem and was born to two ordinary Jews, was the means by which God intended to deliver the world from the pain, suffering, and death that came about because of sin. Jesus Christ began His career as a humble preacher, and He only preached for 3 years, but His words and actions echo down to us today because they have earth-shaking significance. He is the Savior of the world, who died to deliver us from our sins and the punishment of sin. Millions have decided to believe in Him so that they can escape the eternal punishment of sin, which is hell, and have an eternal home in heaven with God. So while you are thinking about what gifts you can give or what gifts you may receive, allow me to share with you what some of the world's most noted individuals have said about Jesus Christ, the gift God gave to the world, the unspeakable gift. As you listen, I encourage you to consider giving your life to Jesus Christ, for that will indeed be the greatest gift you can give to Him. Historian Kenneth Scott LaTourette said, "As the centuries pass, the evidence is accumulating that, measured by His effect on history, Jesus is the most influential life ever lived on this planet." Scientist, educator, and inventor George Washington Carver said, "The Lord has guided me, and without my Savior, I am nothing." Historian Philip Schaff said, "Jesus of Nazareth, without money and arms, conquered more millions than Alexander the Great, Caesar, Muhammad, and Napoleon. Without science and learning, He shed more light on things human and divine than all philosophers and scholars combined. Without the eloquence of school, He spoke such words of life as were never spoken before or since, and produced effects which lie beyond the reach of orator or poet. Without writing a single line, He set more pens in motion and furnished themes for more sermons, orations, discussions, learned volumes, works of art, and songs of praise than the whole army of great men of ancient and modern times. Margaret Thatcher, former Prime Minister of Great Britain, said that our Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, when faced with his terrible choice and lonely vigil, chose to lay down his life that our sins may be forgiven. I remember well a sermon on Armistice Sunday when our preacher said, "No one took away the life of Jesus. He chose to lay it down." India's greatest citizen and political leader, Mahatma Gandhi, said Jesus Christ, who was completely innocent, offered himself as a sacrifice for the good of others, including his enemies, and became the ransom of the world. It was a perfect act. Bono, lead singer for the rock band U2, said, "When people say good teacher or really nice guy, this is not how Jesus thought of himself. You're left with a challenge, which is either Jesus was who he said he was or a complete and utter nutcase. I believe that Jesus was the Son of God. When you align yourself with God's purpose as described in the scriptures, something special happens to your life." French Emperor and military leader Napoleon Bonaparte said, "I know men, and I tell you that Jesus Christ is no mere man. Between him and every person in the world, there is no possible term of comparison." Alexander, Caesar, Charlemagne, and I have founded empires, but on what did we rest the creations of our genius? Upon force. Jesus Christ founded his empire upon love, and at this hour millions of men would die for him. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., the main leader of the civil rights movement in America, said, "By opening our lives to God in Christ, we become new creatures. This experience, which Jesus spoke of as the new birth, is essential if we are to be transformed nonconformists. Only through an inner spiritual transformation do we gain the strength to fight vigorously the evils of the world in a humble and loving spirit." Entertainer and musician Billy Ray Cyrus said, "A lot of people think Christianity is about always being perfect. It's actually the opposite of that. It's realizing that we're all humans. We're not perfect. And that's why God sent his Son to this earth to save people." Scottish novelist Robert Louis Stevenson said, "When Christ came into my life, I came about like a well-handled ship." Superstar actress Angela Bassett said, "When you realize that every breath is a gift from God, when you realize how small you are, but how much he loved you, that he, Jesus, would die, the Son of God himself on earth, then you just weep." The 40th President of the United States, Ronald Reagan, said, "No matter where we live, we have a promise that can make all the difference. a promise from Jesus to soothe our sorrows, heal our hearts, and drive away our fears. He promised there will never be a dark night that does not end, and by dying for us, Jesus showed how far our love should be ready to go, all the way. Reagan also wrote, "This uneducated, propertyless young man, Jesus Christ, has for 2,000 years had a greater effect on the world than all the rulers, kings, emperors, all the conquerors, generals, and admirals, all the scholars, scientists, and philosophers who have ever lived, all of them put together. How do we explain that unless he really was what he said he was?" Historian H.G. Wells said, "I am a historian. I am not a believer, but I must confess as a historian that this penniless preacher from Nazareth is irrevocably the very center of history. Jesus Christ is easily the most dominant figure in all history." Major League Baseball player Adrian Gonzalez said, "Christ has given me a different perspective in life, in my marriage, in my attitude on the field, and in everything else, including trying to be the best husband to my wife as possible, and striving to be the best person I can be. I have success in baseball, but I know that is because of the Lord. I know my preparing and my hard work definitely play a part, but it would not be done without Christ." Russian President Vladimir Putin said, "Why did Christ come into the world? To liberate people from sickness, troubles, from death. In its essence, Christmas is a holiday of hope." Philosopher and physicist Blaise Pascal said, "Without Jesus Christ, man must be in vice and misery. With Jesus Christ, man is free from vice and misery. In him is all our virtue and all our happiness. Apart from him, there is but vice, misery, darkness, death, and despair." Basketball great Julius Irving said, "After searching for the meaning of life for over 10 years, I found the meaning in Jesus Christ. When I gave my life to Jesus Christ, I began to understand my true purpose for being here. It's not to go through life and experience as many things as you possibly can, and then turn to dust and be no more. The purpose of life is to be found through having Christ in your life and understanding what his plan is and following that plan." President Theodore Roosevelt said, "My great joy and glory is that in occupying an exalted position in the nation, I am enabled to preach the practical moralities of the Bible to my fellow countrymen and to hold up Christ as the hope and Savior of the world." Nobel Prize-winning physicist Albert Einstein said, "As a child, I received instruction both in the Bible and in the Talmud. I am a Jew, but I am enthralled by the luminous figure of the Nazarene. No one can read the Gospels without feeling the actual presence of Jesus. His personality pulsates in every word. No myth is filled with such life." NFL quarterback Sam Bradford said, "I really don't see a reason why you wouldn't want to have a relationship with Jesus Christ. I mean, not only was he the greatest human being to ever walk the earth, he's everything that I want to strive for. He's everything that anyone should ever want to strive for. Everyone who's on this earth was blessed because of him. To come into this world and to deny him the opportunity to have a relationship with you is almost a slap in his face." English writer and media personality Malcolm Muggeridge said, "Christ is the only answer to an insane world. They will not understand that the trouble with the Western world civilization is not economics, but more good and evil. They are thinking they can make things work by policies, inventions, but man will never live on this planet without God." R&B great singer, songwriter, and producer Smokey Robinson said, "I know the strength that Christ gives me. I know what he did for me. I know that he is my way out and my way in. He's my way out of all this havoc and my way in to paradise. He suffered for me and for everybody. It's so simple. God loves us so much. He said, I'll tell you what. I'm going to make it real simple for you. I'm going to send my son, Jesus Christ. He's going to take on all your iniquities and all your sins. He's going to die in your place so you can have everlasting life. All you've got to do is accept him as your Savior." Professor and author Wayne Grudem said, "It is by far the most amazing miracle in the whole Bible. Far more amazing than the resurrection and more amazing than the creation of the universe. The fact that the infinite, omnipotent, eternal Son of God could become man and join himself to a human nature, so that infinite God became one person with finite man, will remain for eternity the most profound miracle and the most profound mystery in all the universe." New York Times best-selling author John Grisham said, "I came under conviction when I was in the third grade and I talked with my mother. I told her, I don't understand this, but I need to talk to you. We talked and she led me to Jesus. The following Sunday, I made a public confirmation of my faith in Jesus Christ. In one sense, it was not terribly eventful for an 8-year-old boy, but it was the most important event in my life." The Chinese political and military leader Chiang Kai-shek said, "How I wish that all people would read the Bible, worship and believe in the one and only true God, the Bible, which is God's living, inspired, and true word, teaches us about the triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. It also declares that we can attain righteousness by our faith in His Son, Jesus Christ, who gave Himself through His death on the cross and shed His blood as an offering for sin. God's righteousness by faith in Jesus Christ exalts a nation. That has been proven historically. Christ is freedom's rock. His love covers a multitude of sins. Everyone who believes on Him shall receive eternal life. Super Bowl winning football coach Tom Landry said, "This is really the most important factor in my life, my faith in Jesus Christ." When you accept Christ, He becomes first in your life. It's this priority that gives me peace. Irish playwright George Bernard Shaw said, "I am no more of a Christian than Pilate was, or you are, gentle hearer. And yet, like Pilate, I greatly prefer Jesus of Nazareth to Amos or Caiaphas, and I am ready to admit that I see no way out of the world's misery but the way which would have been found by His will." Dear friend, do you know this wonderful person named Jesus Christ? Have you received His unspeakable gift? Have you given your life to Him as the greatest gift that you can give back to Him? No gift you have received nor ever will receive can compare to the gift God has made available to you through His Holy Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And the greatest gift you can give is your life to Jesus Christ by accepting Him as your personal Savior, by believing on the Lord Jesus Christ and receiving salvation from your sins and the punishment of sin, which is hell, as many of those I just quoted and millions of others down through the years have done. Ladies and gentlemen, this Christmas season, allow me to show you how you can receive the greatest gift ever given, which the Bible refers to as the unspeakable gift, salvation through Jesus Christ, and then how you can give the greatest gift you can give to Jesus Christ, and that is your life. First, dear friend, accept the fact that you are a sinner and that you have broken God's laws at some point in your life. I know that's hard to hear, but it is true. The Bible says in Ecclesiastes 7:20, "For there is not a just man upon earth that doeth good and sinneth not." Romans 3:23 reads, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." In fact, I am the chief of sinners, so don't think that you're all by yourself. You're not. We all have done wrong in our lives. Second, accept the fact that there is a penalty, a punishment for sin. The Bible says in Romans 6:23, "For the wages of sin is death." Rather, we die physically because of sin. We also die spiritually because of sin. I'll show you that further in a minute. Third, accept the fact that you are on the road to hell because of sin. Jesus Christ said in Matthew 10:28, "And fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul." but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. The Bible says in Revelation 21:8, but the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars. If you have ever told one lie, that includes you. All liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. Fourth, accept the fact that you cannot do anything to save yourself. The Bible states in Ephesians 2:8-9, for by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Fifth, accept the fact that God loves you more than you love yourself, and that he wants to save you from hell. Jesus Christ said in John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Dear friend, with these truths in mind, please believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, that he died on the cross for your sins, that he was buried and rose again, and pray and ask him to come into your heart to save your soul this very moment. It will be the greatest gift that you have ever received, and you'll be given to him the greatest gift that you can give to him, and that is your life. The Bible says in the book of Romans 10:9, that if you shall confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shall believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. Verse 13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Now, dear friend, if you are willing to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ for your salvation, that he died for your sins, was buried and rose from the dead on the third day, please pray with me this simple prayer. Mean it from your heart. Holy Father God, I realize that I am a sinner and that I have done some bad things in my life. For Jesus Christ's sake, please forgive me of my sins, my failures, and my faults. I now believe with all of my heart that Jesus Christ died for me, was buried, and rose from the dead on the third day. Lord Jesus, please come into my heart and save my soul and change my life today and forever. Amen. Beloved, if you believed in your heart that Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sins, was buried, and then rose again on the third day, allow me to say congratulations on doing the most important thing in life, and that is trusting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And I guarantee you that you will never regret it. For more information to help you grow in your newfound faith in Christ, go to GospelLightSociety.com and read what to do after you enter through the door. Jesus Christ said in John 10:9, I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pasture. Dear friend, God loves you. We love you. May God bless you. And Merry Christmas.